Good morning, fans, PrivateerFX. Coming at you 26 May. You know, a lot happened yesterday, but a little bit happened, right? It wasn't as volatile as we would like. Kind of grindy. The big move was oil, down 5%. Still not super clear why that happened. We were busy. A bunch of meetings yesterday. A bunch of, like, in and out. Oil got smashed. No horse in this race, but that's noteworthy day in oil. As we put on Twitter yesterday, we bought some gold. We're trying to accumulate some gold here down towards 35. 38 the low last night. You know, we just feel like a lot of the pent-up purchases from 1950 all the way up to 2080 were puked through 1950 yesterday. And if we can close back above 1950 now, it looks pretty constructive. But, you know, gold, it just depends on how this inflation number comes out today, 2:30 Swiss time. Dollar yen, we sold 50s yesterday. That did not work out for us. Stopped out 78. The high was, 140.27? I don't know. Like, I don't understand dollar yen. Inflation's super hot in Japan. I feel like they're going to change monetary policy. When they do, this thing's going to drop 20 big figures. And you're going to, like, be kissing 119. But, you know, for now, I guess, you know, the 5% carry is the 5% carry. So dollar yen has been a thorn in our side all month. Aussie, very stretched yesterday, as you can see. Down to 90. We own some Aussie CAD, which is kind of a pairs type mean reversion trade. Also just on the stretch. I don't understand why Aussie, which is a risk sort of barometer currency pair, got hit so hard. S&Ps have done nothing, right? We're 42.10, we're 41.10, but now we're 41.50. I feel like, you know, Aussie should be right in the middle as well. And where's the middle? 68 the high, 65 the low. Aussie should be at sort of 66.50. Does it mean revert? Who knows? Let's see. Euro, also same deal. We traded this pretty well yesterday, so now we have a good average. Who was at 107.15 yesterday? Did you guys watch that? I mean, there was someone big at 15 yesterday. Obviously, in the end, he got filled in, and there were a couple stops just below from little short-term guys who also noticed this huge buyer at 15. But it's constructive when you see that. We haven't seen that in a while. There was just, you know, some monster accumulating euros at 15. I wonder if he's thinking, or I wonder if he's following Privateer. Maybe he bought 4 yards because he listens to Privateer on YouTube. But interesting stuff. You'd have to question a lot of things if we make a new low today. But again, this is PCE related, so it's kind of just binary. 2:30 today. If this is a soft one, the dollar can get hurt, right? It's gone up 4% in a straight line. There are no more dollar shorts out there. There are probably a few, you know, trend followers who are dollar longs. A lot of things could happen if it's a soft one today, but if it's super hot, it's just more of the same. So let's just see 2:30 today how things go. Rates 3.80. This is why the dollar is higher. We basically 3:30 to 3.80. 3.89 is the resistance. You kind of wish that we had some sort of long wicked candle up to 3.89 to sort of mark a turn. That is a bullish rates day, a yield day, right? Yesterday closed at the highs, 382. This has to turn for the dollar to go down. So keep an eye on rates. If you own some gold, if you own some euros, keep an eye on rates. If you own Aussie CAD, you don't have to care about that as much. Just sit tight. What else out there? Dollar Norway, we talked about selling high ones. It did trade 07 yesterday. If you are short, I suggest you sell again back through 11. This is like a Kaiser Sose move, right? If you got paid on a high one, you add to it on weakness and then just put your stop above yesterday's high. This is a combination of weaker dollar and weaker oil. This thing is also stretched. It's come from 1040 dollar Norway. Not for the faint-hearted, that's for sure. Look, there are no real great setups out here this morning in Europe. We just have to kind of wait now for PCE. In reduced liquidity, Memorial Day is obviously on Monday, Pentecost. Pentecôte, as they say in French-speaking Switzerland, is also a holiday here. I believe it's a bank holiday in the UK. Like, everybody's on holiday, so there's going to be reduced liquidity today with Monday off, so be aware. If this is an outlier at 2:30, there will be some vol. All right, I'm going to just leave you to that, and I'm going to get on with my morning. Going to really bear down and get ready for some action. 2:30 today, PCE. Good luck out there, people.